Esther, your Foreign Secretary really interests me. I mean, apart from his appalling performance on Celebrity Mastermind a few years ago, now saying he can make common cause with a Nazi Ku Klux Klan supporter. Or is he just admitting he's been a typical left-wing idiot about Trump all along?
I think it's certainly more the latter than the former. David Lammy is an interesting one, but actually all the sort of leading members of the new cabinet are also culprits of this. You have Keir Starmer, Angela Rayner, David Lammy, all of these people in the new government that have made disparaging remarks about President Trump, and now that they're in government have had to row back and pretend to be diplomatic and nice. With King Charles, it's interesting, and this is why this is another thing that stresses the importance of actually having a monarchy and not being a republic, because once you politicize the head of state, you might have had a situation where a President Lammy would have to row back on his comments. The late Queen, like King Charles is aware, knew that she had to be diplomatic and remain neutral, because it doesn't matter who you meet, you're representing your country, and he's taken a leaf out of her book. Unfortunately, our politicians can't seem to do that. And the thing is, Trump has a very good memory. He's not going to forget David Lammy's comments, and neither is he going to forget Keir Starmer or Angela Rayner's comments about him in the past. And that could actually mar relations between the UK and the US moving forward. Donald Trump is almost certainly going to be the next president of the United States. And if they come back from the US with their tail between their legs because they couldn't secure any sort of favorable deal because of comments they made 7-8 years ago, that's not going to look very good to the British public.
Now, Esther, there's other things that amaze and even disturb me, really, about your new Labour government. I am worried, Esther, how much longer your lights are going to stay on in Britain. You know, you've got this new government. It's so bought the global warming thing. It's slapped a ban on finding new reserves of oil in the North Sea. It's reversed the decision to approve a new coal mine in Cumbria. Is all this global warming awareness smart when your country is already very dangerously short of electricity?
Yes, this is one of the things that we don't seem to understand, the lack of continuity when it comes to our energy policy. And I actually think this is one of those issues that shouldn't be partisan. Energy, security, law and order, these are the things that should be really cross-partisan so we can ensure some sort of continuity. You also find that, you know, they're releasing criminals early because we haven't built enough prisons. On energy, in the same way, we don't have a decent energy mix because we would rather close down oil and gas pipelines, sell off what we have, what we produce in terms of oil and gas, and then import oil and gas from other countries instead of using our own domestic supply. It simply beggars belief. And that this is something that's been undertaken by Ed Miliband is not surprising either. This is what happens when you have leaders who don't think ahead and are used to this sort of short-term destructive thinking. We already have one of the highest energy prices in the developed world, and it's only going to be increasing. These are the kinds of things that dissuade investment and are going to negatively affect businesses in the future. But unfortunately, we're going to have to learn that the hard way, because this is not a surprising development with the Labour government.
It's weird because here's a Labour government pursuing middle-class obsessions that are going to hurt the poor most of all. You mentioned the prisons. I mean, this is amazing. You know, you've got your Prime Minister admitting, we're going to release thousands of prisoners to stop overcrowding of the prisons. I would have thought the answer would be build more prisons or something like that. Silly me. Is this a popular move?
Of course not. I mean, one of the things that people have been talking about is the fact that we have a lot of foreign national offenders in our prisons that cannot be sent back home to be deported. We have about 12,000, at my last count, 12,000 FINOs, as they're called, foreign national offenders, that cannot be deported, that are stuck here in this country, occupying prison spaces. We have 14,000 people in prison for drug offences like owning marijuana. These are all questions that 20 years of governments could have solved, 20 years of successive governments could have solved, but they've refused to. And unfortunately, it looks like Labour is just kicking the can down the road. I mean, they're releasing people that haven't even served half of their sentences. That's how tragic the situation is.
You're kidding me. That's unbelievable. Jeez, if you were a victim of some of those criminals, you'd be so upset. Esther Krakue, always great to talk to you. Thank you so much for your time.